Hi everyone, in this video, I will show you how to add nice looking buttons and banner with animation for your Google Sites. Canva is a graphic design platform that allows users to create graphics, presentations, posters, and other visual content. It provides thousands of templates, clip arts, and stock images. What's really cool is it provides pro features that are free for educators. If you're interested in learning how to sign up for their free education account, please check out my other tutorial video link below. To create a banner for your site, go to canva.com and click the Create a Design button on top. Then type in Google Classroom Banner. Once you enter the design page, you will see some pre-made templates by Canva. I just picked the ones I like and changed the text for my site. So far, the banner templates provided can only be saved as still images. If you want to learn how to create an animated banner from scratch on Canva, please watch my other tutorial video. This video link is also shared in the video description. Next, I will show you how to make buttons. Go back to the homepage and hit the Create a Design button again. Type in logo. This will give you a blank square template and it fits nicely for round buttons. I really like the watercolor designs on Canva, and there are so many to choose from. So I'm going to use these designs as the backgrounds for my buttons. Go to the Elements tab, type in watercolor circle, or add a specific color word. You can also filter the elements by colors by clicking the three line icon next to the search bar. Now that I picked the watercolor background, I'm going to add a white circle on top to complete the look. I just search circle in the Elements tab, then pick a thin open circle. To change the color of the circle, just select the circle and click the color icon on top. I changed the color to white, so it's more visible. Now we can resize, move, and rotate the circle to your liking. I've decided to make this button for my math resources page, so I'm going to add an animated laptop icon. You can search laptop in the Elements tab, then click the three line icon next to the search bar. Select animated and apply filters. You can also flip the animation, resize and remove it. Next, we will head to the text tab and embed the page name on this button. Change the text color to white so it's easy to identify. To make the text look nicer, you can also change its effect to lift. The next button I want to make is a contact me button, so parents and students can just click the button and email me. For this one, I will choose a rounded watercolor background and add a perfect white dotted circle. The next button I'm going to create is for my assignments page. I search homework and pick this clip art I like. Since it's white color, I want to choose a darker background to make it pop. If you delete an element and add a new one, you will see that it covers the previous element. You can right click and send to back so that you will see the element added before this. I will recommend to download buttons with animation and buttons with still images separately. To do that, click the down arrow button next to download and change the file type to GIF or GIF. Then select one page at a time to download the buttons with animation. I tried to download all GIF buttons at once, but Canva only saved one page. However, for still images, you can download them all together. Select PNG as the file type, click transparent background, and select all pages you want to save as still images. Here is an example to show you why you need to save the buttons with transparent background. If you choose to add dark color background image on your site, you can see the buttons fit nicely there. Unfortunately, this will only work for PNG images. I haven't figured out a way to make a GIF image with transparent background. If you know how to do that, please share in comments below. I will really appreciate that. The next part of this video will show you how to add the banner and buttons on your Google site. Open sites.google.com. Once you are on the site's page, you can either click the Create button and choose in New Sites, or click the New Google Sites option underneath. This will bring you to the page with templates ready to be used. If you want to start from scratch, click a blank template. The first thing you will see is the home page of your site. So there are two ways to add your banner, depending on how you want to show your banner image. The first way is to move your mouse over the header and select Change Image, then upload your design. Since mine has transparent background, I will change the theme to get white background. Notice there's gray overlay on the banner. You can make it disappear by clicking the star icon on the bottom right corner of your banner. My website name is already embedded in the image, so I will just delete the text in the title text box. Now when I preview the site page, I see that it's stretched to fit the whole top part. But one thing I notice is, part of the banner will be cut out if you view the site in tablet mode or cell phone mode. So I usually use the second method to make sure my whole banner shows in all three modes. To do that, you will first delete the whole header section. Then select images on the right side and upload your banner. Now just drag and resize it until you see the whole banner image. With this method, the image won't fit the site page all the way from left to right, but it will make sure the whole banner is shown in cell phone mode and tablet mode. Finally, I'm going to add the buttons I've just created on Canva. Choose a layout to your liking. Click each plus sign and upload your PNG or GIF files. You can type the page name under each button, or you can delete the text boxes if the names are already on the button images. To link each button to a specific page on my site, I will need to create new pages. You can add as many pages as you want by clicking the plus sign. After naming each page, go back to the home page and select one button image. Click the insert link icon on top of the image. So for my homework button, I will choose the assignments page. For the contact me button, you can enter your email address as a link. If you don't want to show the subpages at the navigation bar, click the three dots icon next to each page and choose Hide from Navigation. To make sure visitors can go back to the homepage after I hide the subpages, I just create another button and link it to the homepage of my Google site. Now, when you enter the preview mode, you should be able to click each button and it will bring you to the designated page. Thank you for watching my video. If you enjoyed this video, be sure to hit the like button and subscribe to my channel. Until next time!